been in corporate representatives.
Mm-hmm.
I'm ladies there before them.
Yeah.
Right, hello, and welcome to Tito the Troddler. And as Monty Python used to say, now for something completely different. You see, my channel's not just about one genre. No, not just one genre. Yes, it's multifaceted. One week you might be in the Yorkshire Dales. The next week you might be doing a travel vlog. The week after that it might be something to do with history. Sometimes people say, so how would you describe yourself? And that's a tough question to answer because, being honest, I'm a bit of an enigma. I'm like ubiquitous. Ubiquitous, can't even say it. I'm everywhere, I'm everywhere. So I would say the best way to describe it is, really, I'm like a fragrance. Yeah, a fragrance that would smell a little bit like a cross between new cut grass, a trump inside a sleeping bag, with maybe a bit of Girondins wine and Ardbeg, yeah. And a whiff of Ardbeg thrown in for good measure. Right, so if you haven't guessed, we're in the market and spa town of Knaresborough. Beautiful, beautiful place on a beautiful, beautiful day. So we're just trying to avoid people, don't want to get in the way of anybody's thing, but there's plenty to eat and drink and lots to see, so we're really looking forward to this, so welcome along to the journey. So first things first, because obviously it's always important that you start somewhere, and we're going to start, and I've nicked this off another channel, we're going to start with a sausage roll-off. So we've got Hutton's shop across there, Butcher's across the road, so we're going to go in there and get a sausage roll from them. Then we're going to go up the road to another one called Appleton's and get a sausage roll from them. We're going to decide which is the best. And it's going to be like a fistful of dollars, really, because we're only 2 minutes apart, really. So I'll be interested to see which is the best. But that's going to be the start of the day, and then we're going to get on to something else. But this should be good. And then the other place we've got is over here, is Appleton's. So that's the competition, is that? So we're going to go, we'll just get one from there and then we'll have a bit of a taste off. It must be good because there's a queue. Right, so here we have it. Here's a sausage off. So on the left we've got Hutton's, and on the right we've got Hutton's, and on the left we've got Appleton's. So let's see which is the best. I'll give you an opinion in a moment. Right, both absolutely excellent. I've got to say, I really enjoyed both of them. The winner, without a shadow of a doubt, is definitely Hutton's. Absolutely magnificent. It's more like you get like a slice rather than a roll, and it's just a really lovely sausage meat. So really, really nice. But yeah, both absolutely excellent. Both were brilliant, but Hutton's wins hands down. Right, so we're here at Mother Shipton's Cave, a very famous Yorkshire landmark, and Mother Shipton is one of the most famous prophetiers, if you want to call it, not prophetiers, prophecies. She made lots of prophecies, and she was really, really famous for it. So she reckoned she could predict the future. She talked about the Great Fire of London, and she talked about the invasion of the Spanish Armada. And some people thought she was a witch, which obviously back then could be a bit risky. Anyhow, she died after a long life in 1561, aged 73. And Mother Shipton was actually born Ursula Sentinel in 1488, and that was during the reign of Henry VII and Henry VIII. Although she knew little about her parents, legend has it that she was born during a violent thunderstorm in a cave on the banks of the River Nid, so that's why we're here. Her mother, Agatha, was 15 years old when she gave birth, and despite being dragged before the local magistrate, she would not reveal who the father was. I wonder if it was somebody really important. with no family or friends to support, Agatha raised Ursula in the cave on her own for 2 years before the abbots of Beverley took pity on her and took Ursula in. So that was took Agatha in to the convent. So Ursula grew up in Knaresborough and she's considered a strange child. Her nose was large and crooked and her back bent, so she had all the afflictions of a witch. They spent most of her days around the cave and in the forest. And she were when she was 24, she met a guy called Tobias Shipton, and he was a carpenter from the city of York. So she took his name, but Ursula kept his name. And Mother Shipton, as I say, the rest is history. So that is more or less the history of Mother Shipton. So obviously we've got this petrified cave that turns objects into stone to look forward to. So it should be pretty good. But yeah, been a long time getting here. So let's see what it's like. Oh goodness me, it's a warm one, a real, real warm one. So anyhow, obviously we've done the tourist a bit, so we've done Mother Shipton's cave and we've had a bit of wander about. We were going to take a punt down the river, but decided not to bother with rowing boat over thought it would take too long anyhow. So the real reason we're obviously come to Knaresborough is to visit a few pubs. So pub number one is the Mother Shipton Inn. A Mullen Chipton Inn is a 16th century coaching inn, and it's obviously located at the side of the River Nid near Low Bridge, and it is a Grade 2 listed building, and it was first listed in 1968. It's apparently got a rustic interior, and it's always got whitewashed walls and an old porch, and the inn, it features obviously the name of the prophet or prophetess, Mullen Chipton. So anyhow, most importantly, I just hope they serve a nice, really, really nice ice cold cider, and then we'll be laughing. Right, so pub number one finished up. Mullen Chipton Inn on the side of the bridge. So now on to number two, the Half Moon. Can't really tell you much about this because it doesn't look that old, to be fair. So I don't know where it dates back from. Can't find anything online. But it closed in 2011 and it's opened back up in 2018. And it's run by a brewery from Chorley that manages a number of pubs. But it looks like they've done a tidy job with it. So we'll give it a bash for number two. Great thing about all these pubs, I think there's 23 within a walking distance. So I think we're doing eight today. And I think longest walk's 5 minutes. So should be a good crawl, should this. Right, just a couple of things to say. First of all, just come out of the Half Moon, and I've got to say, we found a picture on the wall that means it's at least 100 years old, so it's older than I thought it was, because there's this beautiful old picture up on the wall that's got this young lad in the doorway, and it looks a fabulous photograph anyhow, so that's it. Just one thing, I'm going to get on to the next point in a moment, but I just want to tell you something really quickly is, just as we're getting on training, Keith, today, conductor gave a little kid who was about two, who was sat in a pram, a pretend ticket, and you should have seen the lad's face when I give him it. I mean, you know, when you're 2 and 3 years of age, it's a lot better than somebody giving you your own train ticket, but they were absolutely over the moon waving away. But I just thought, I love people doing selfless things, and that work, that's the best selfless thing I've seen today. It was absolutely fantastic. So, without any further ado, we're on to pub number three. So this is the George and the Dragon. And the George and the Dragon is red brick, Flemish bond, Westmoreland slate roof, two-storey first floor windows, rendered plinth below the window sill. So 20th century, central 20th century door, so it always had some adjustments from the late 18th century, which is when it was first thing. Obviously, bold sash windows, glazing bars, and wooden eaves, band and gutter brackets. So so it was listed in 1952, so they obviously went and made a bit of an effort in the 50s to list quite a lot of the Knaresborough pubs. But an absolute, certainly from the outside, certainly looks the part. So we'll see what it looks like inside. But yeah, George and the Dragon, that's number three. Right, we're now outside the Cross Keys. The Cross Keys just across the road here. And the Cross Keys, well, there's a couple of things to tell you about the Cross Keys. First of all, it dates back to the 18th and 19th century, and but it could be like, it used to be a Tetley's pub, but the best bit about it all is that it's now owned by the Ossett Brewery, which can only mean one thing. There's got to be a pint of white right in here, which that'll do for me. But yeah, it's obviously got a bit of Georgian style windows and what have you. Very, very nice. I don't know if it's listed or not, but let's go inside and see what it's like. Right, next up is the Market Tavern at Castlegate, so there you go. So I ain't got a lot of history about this place. It's really been recently purchased by Market Taverns sort of group. So I don't know, it looks a bit Georgian in appearance to me, the architecture of the building. So I don't know if that's the case or not. We're going to have a look inside and see what it is. I'm not sure there's that much history connected to this, but it's been refurbed in 2020, so probably not many, got many original features, but a stop nonetheless. Right, next one on the agenda is the Old Royal Oak, as you can see. So as it says, established in 1794, and it's in the market square, so you can sort of see the market square of Knaresborough there, and the pub dates, like I said, dates back to the 18th century, and it's even got its own priest hall somewhere, where all priests used to hide when they thought they were going to get tortured for being Catholic. So that's it, yeah, but it was listed in 1985, so in a moment we'll go inside and have a look around and see what it looks like inside. But we've got this, and I think we've got two others, and that's it. We're done and dusted for today. So all good fun, it's been a good trip so far. It's a really lovely place, is Knaresborough. The pubs are not as maybe authentic as some of the other places I've been to, like Manchester and what have you, but it's been a good trip nonetheless, and obviously weather's helped because it's been so fantastic. But yeah, that's the old Royal Oak. Right, time's moving on, so we're now outside Blind Jack's Traditional Ale House. And Blind Jack's Traditional Ale House was actually formed in 1991, so that wasn't that long ago. But it's located in the Market Square here in Knaresborough, and it's a Grade 2 listed building. The building goes back to 1741, and I think there were another chemist next door that, or somewhere that beats it by 20 years to 1720. Well, that's forgetting that the market itself goes back to 1240, so end of day. There's a lot of old stuff around here, that's all you need to know.
Yeah.
So, a bit of history, why is it called Blind Jack's? Well, Blind Jack is a bit of a folk hero in Knaresborough. He was born in 1717 as John Metcalfe and became permanently blind after a bout of smallpox when he was 6 years old. He then had a very colourful career. After being a fiddle player, a tour guide and a soldier, he became an extremely talented road builder, constructing over 180 miles of road across northern England, whilst being completely blind. A couple of sash windows to the right of the pub have been repurposed into a lovely mural. We'll have to see if we can find that. He's there with his fiddle. And also, just across the road is there's a statue there on a bench, and you can sit next to him, of Blind Jack, and you can sit there and he can pretend that he's his mate. But yeah, I really love it. So I love stuff like this. It's the same as like in Edinburgh, the stories that you get behind the pubs are good. So this one isn't very old, but the story behind it is absolutely fantastic. So yeah, get yourself to Blind Jack's. Right, here we are. So this is the last stop here now, the Castle Inn. Always a warm welcome, I agree with that, yeah. So it used to be the Castle Vaults, and it dates back to the mid-18th century. And it's obviously got some sash windows and all the rest of it, so very, very nice. Listed in 1952, just like about every other pub in Knaresborough, so obviously whoever got his pee in his bonnet about listing pubs got some traction, because he got a lot of them sorted out and all the rest of it. But, you know, can I just say, you know, it's like... this trip round there, the place has been absolutely fantastic. 23 pubs, I don't know how anybody does it. We're just across the road from Appleton's Butchers as well, so that's good. But no, it's been absolutely fabulous, and we've had a great time. Everything, you know, we've got time to come back. Need to have a road out river next time. But you know, it's been a really good trip, and we've really enjoyed it. So this is the last of the pubs, number 8. So I'm going to say goodbye now, and I'm just going to say thank you for watching as always. And you know, subscribe, thumbs up, all that, carry on. But I'd highly recommend Knaresborough to anybody. It's a great day out, or even if you come for a weekend, if you can afford it. Really, really worthwhile. It's beautiful. So thank you so much, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.